San Salvador, these voters are cheering for change. But this presidential election is set to be a close race. At stake is the future of one of Central America's most troubled nations. And the two main candidates offer very different visions for the future. 69-year-old former guerrilla commander Salvador Sanchez is no stranger to politics. He's been the vice president for the past 5 years for the socialist FMLN party and has pledged to extend welfare programs and create jobs. But Sanchez is facing a tough race from Norman Quijano, the former mayor of San Salvador. His right-wing Arena party has promised to crack down on gangs by using El Salvador's armed forces. In the streets of San Salvador, it's the poorest voters who may very well decide who wins, and many have deep concerns about their children.
I fear for my kids because many times young people are forced to join the gangs, not only the gangs but other criminal groups like drug traffickers. And if they don't accept, they are forced into it.
This is a deeply divided nation where middle-class Salvadorians live behind gated communities, but all are united in their fear of violence.
And it's crime and how to solve it that is defining this entire election. The FMLN has pledged to give the police more resources to take on the gangs. Arena has a far less compromising approach with talk of military courts and using the armed forces. But for voters fed up of a fragile truce between the gangs and living in fear, it's the one issue that may well decide who is this country's next president.
A truce between rival gangs has been in place for 2 years, but the killings have continued. Analysts say whoever wins will inherit a problem that won't easily be fixed.
The gangs are a serious issue that must be confronted because the country cannot wait any longer. The people of El Salvador already paid a great price from the war in the 80s, and this problem is even worse than that.
El Salvador's brutal civil war, which led to the deaths of 75,000 people, ended in 1992. Former President Francisco Flores is currently being investigated for corruption, a move that won't inspire confidence in an already uncertain electorate. Andy Gallagher, Al Jazeera, San Salvador.